On the behalf of Shashikant Sharma, myself RJ Bhandari is presenting from SAC ISRO.
Okay, yeah, please go ahead.
So there are 10 problems. So I will go one by one, and what exactly we have to do for that problem, and what will be the requirement, and what will be expecting from the students or participants. Okay, let us take first one: mapping of natural resources or a man-made features. So basically, we have to map the natural resources like agriculture area or forest area, water bodies, or man-made features like built-up area. So any man-made constructions. So that kind of resources can be mapped. So to map these features, what will be the requirement? We need remote sensing data like LIS-4 data or LIS-3 data. So this type of data will be required, and one has to learn how to interpret the imagery. So we have to interpret the imagery, and we have to extract the information from the imagery. So we have to work out, okay, what type of tone or texture or a color will be the reflecting, means resembling the particular features. So identification of the features on the imagery. So it requires the skill to interpret the imagery, as well as some ground knowledge also is required. And after knowing all these things, we have to do the automatic extraction of the features. So for that, computer-based image processing also is required. And all this type of input data will be available on the BOOON. So one can take this type of problem and work out flowchart for it, and one by one step can be executed, and finally come out as a map, thematic map. Thematic means it is a represents particular subject. So come out with some particular subject map or a thematic map. So that will be the output. And if you see second problem, so that is change detection based on AVIPS or LIS-3 data sets. So what type of change detection? Any suppose say forest area, what was the before, then this date. So two type of database we have to take and interpret both the data sets, whether visually or digitally, and then overlay to both the data set and come out with the change. So one has to work out all the steps and flowcharts and execute it one by one and come out with the change map as well as change statistics. Okay, then third one is LULC, land use land cover change with hotspots using land use land cover maps available from the BOOON. So we have on the BOOON 250,000 scale as well as 50,000 scale data sets. One can directly download this ready-made dataset, use it, and come out with change. Particular change wherever hotspots means dynamic changing area means some significant change should be observed. So that change map one has to prepare as a output and come out with the statistic how much change is there. Then fourth problem, flood mapping. So we observed that in India, at many places, flooding is happening in every monsoon season, like in Bihar, Kosi River, Brahmaputra. So at many places, we observe the flood. So we have to map the flood. For that, we have to consider pre and post season data sets. So post pre-monsoon, just you observe that what will be the normal condition, and then post monsoon, how much area is inundated. So that area will maps we have to prepare, means one has to prepare and come out with the statistic how much area is gone under the inundation. Then state-wise healthcare indicators maps. So this type of database one has to take from the health department or that sites, and then healthcare map indicators one can find out and prepare the healthcare maps. So there is not much remote sensing data sets roles. Then sixth one is locust infestations. stubble burning, low-lying area mapping, zoom cultivation. So we observed that at many places there is a locust attacks, and in particularly in Punjab, you can find out stubble burning means residue, crop residue. They burn it for next cropping to clear this residue for next cropping season. So to find out this type of area, one has to take that seasonal images and interpret that those area particularly, and find out how much area is under stubble burning. Then low-lying area, particularly where in monsoon season it goes under flooding, means water gets accumulated in the low-lying area. So for this type of study, you can use DEM and find out slope so that you can find out low-lying area. And in case of zoom cultivation, particularly this type of phenomena observed in the northeast area, in hilly area particularly. So in the northeast area, what happens every year or for a particular season, people used to burn the forest area and clear some patches for that agriculture purpose, agriculture practices. So this type of practices is happening in northeast area. So for that, you have to study the images wherever these forest patches are gone, means vanishing. And those area one has to map. And over a period of time, they take one or two crop or a 1 or 2 year, they do the practices, and then they left over those area for natural regeneration. So this type of phenomena we have to interpret from the imageries and bring out with the map, and how much this zoom cultivation area is gone under the agriculture area or under the cultivation. Then in case of transportation networks, linear networks mapping. So for this, high resolution imagery is required, particularly cartoset kind of imageries. So that imageries can be used, and linear features can be extracted either visually or digitally. And drainage map, in case of drainage map, it is, of course, it is of some, at some level it is observed on the image, but DEM is the better. You can directly derive these imageries from the DEM, cartoset DEM. Then land degradation maps. So this is actually a map of a desertification area or a land which is undergoing under degradation. So some processes one has to interpret on the imageries and bring out the land degradation map, whether it is degraded or under good condition. Like one example, water erosion, then wind erosion, vegetation degradation. See, you can observe, okay, previously it was a good area, good green area, and then now some vegetation is going under degradation. So this kind of land degradation maps can be prepared and come out with the final outputs of the map and area statistic. Then health infrastructure, population, age group, etc. for vaccination. So this kind of data can be available from this NIC, National Informatics Center, means tabular information, not much role of remote sensing. And then 10th one is detection of change in water bodies, reservoir, and wetlands. So for this, two time frame database is required, and you can map, generate map of two time frame database, integrate it, and come out with the changes, whether water body is shrinking or it is expanding, or whether reservoir, number of reservoir are increased, or a wetland area is increased. So this kind of studies can be done and come out with the wetland changes map or water body changes map. So this final map can be done. And 11th is means can be taken your own topic. So these are about the topics of the mapathon. Okay, that is all from our side.
Are there any questions? We can take some if there is. Shivanand, any questions from the YouTube?
Yes, so one question was, will ISRO be allowing all this data even after the completion of this event, like Mapathon? Will that data be available for them to use?
Yeah, in general, on that Bhuvan website, a lot of data is available free of cost every time. But here, in some special cases, we will be taking permission. So suppose if you require some high resolution data or anything, we will try to take permission, but it will be available only for Mapathon participants only, because all, I mean, general rules, whatever things are available, that we cannot make it for, I mean, indefinite.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Shivan, just add that in the comment. Okay. Like,
yes.
Okay. Yeah. We'll hold on till then. And then one question which came is how to download the data. I think Shivan, you should reply to that saying there will be a live demo for one problem statement.
Yes.
I think that is, just tell them that on the webinar, I think it is the third event, demonstration of an example by Mr. Nilay Nishant. Okay, just tell them that we will show you how to download it one, and you can use that to use the information to download other data using ISRO resources, like the resources we have.
Yes, okay, sir.
For each platform, they've given us videos, right? Mosdag, Vedas, etc. And how to download Bhuvan Vedas Mosdag, there is YouTube link. So just ask them to go to that. We won't be making, tell them clearly, we won't be making, you know, just videos for this event.
Yes, sir.
There will be a separate session by Arul for downloading the data, how to download data from Bhuvan. Because largest number of data is available on Bhuvan. So that people have to understand very thoroughly.
Okay, sir.
Yes. Because there was one question about lists three or four, I think, and demonstration, etc. So, yeah, after Mr. Arul's presentation, just tell them that there will be a live demo using QGIS, how to, you know, download this data and do a one problem statement. I think that will help them a lot.
Okay, sir.
That could be added as a comment. Huh? Shivanam, just add that as a comment if that same question comes also.
Okay, sir.